This is how Phoebe Bridgers and Casey Musgraves are stealing from Elliot Smith.
Okay, I know, so before you jump down my throat, I love Phoebe Bridgers and I love Casey Musgraves, okay? So do not hate me. I want to point out some similarities between the music so that you can understand the influence, and then I'm going to go into a rant at the end about why it's okay, so just
give me a second.
Phoebe Bridgers became an indie rock darling when she released Stranger in the Alps in 2017. In 2020, she followed up Stranger in the Alps with Punisher, which is an even better album, and since then, she's become more ubiquitous than Timothée Chalamet in literally any Hollywood movie. But to understand Phoebe Bridgers, first we have to understand Elliot Smith, her main influence. Elliot Smith was a 90s singer-songwriter who typically played on acoustic guitar or piano, recorded directly to an 8-track tape, giving him a low-fidelity sound, and double-tracked his vocals. Elliot Smith tragically died by suicide, and his music is extremely sad. So Elliot Smith's music had a lot of common motifs to it, which gave him his own signature sound, but there's one motif that Phoebe Bridgers uses, and now the rest of the music industry is starting to use as well. Check out this motif by dissecting Elliot Smith's song, Say Yes.
I'm in love with the world through the eyes of a girl who's still around the morning after.
Who's still around the morning after.
All right, so notice that one of Elliot Smith's signature moves is to go to the 2-chord. So we're in the key of F, goes to the G, makes it a dominant 7, and over top of that dominant 7, he sings after.
Now let's look at the Phoebe Bridgers song, Savior Complex.
See that one chord, 2-chord, dominant 7. Pissing contest kind of sounds like a lyric that Elliot Smith would write as well. Example number 3, Angel by Casey Musgraves.
Everything would be better, I'd never have to change, I'd never have to change.
Never have to change.
Contest, have to change.
The morning.
Not to mention the production on the new Casey Musgraves features a lot of double-track vocals that sound very airy, very hissy, tape-like, with some acoustic guitar, even some Spanish guitar, which was another Elliot Smith move. Listen to the song Needle in the Hay.
Check this out. Here's what's happening. The ghost of Elliot Smith is inhabiting Phoebe Bridgers and Casey Musgraves. Even look at the titles of the song, Savior Complex and Angel. Elliot Smith is watching over us.